My family came from a farming background, didn't know what the internet was, didn't know what a computer was, didn't care about either. So I don't think my first computer was until Vista, running one of the Core 2 Duos. Let me know down below where you started. Back then, I wasn't using Linux, didn't know what Linux was, but it was our first family PC. Now, a system like that is still functional. You can use it as a computer, but most people have long since moved on to things even just a little bit faster, right? Even the people that really like the old ThinkPads usually aren't running a system that old and that underpowered. However, whilst legacy software support on Linux might be a little bit lacking, when we're talking about legacy hardware support, man, Linux is the king here. You can run some random weird old systems, and in a lot of cases, maybe not on every distro, but at least on something like a Debian, in a lot of cases, you're pretty much just gonna be good. However, whilst the code may be in the code base, that doesn't mean old hardware is being frequently tested. And sometimes there are kernel regressions, and sometimes there are kernel regressions for multiple years because nobody actually went to test it and, you know, tested it extensively enough to really see a problem. Seemingly first reported a few months back, regression. System is stuck in clock source, greater than 60 second delay at boot time without TSC equals unstable. Hi, while upgrading from Debian Bullseye kernel 5.10 to Bookworm 6.1, I noticed that the newer kernel is at the beginning of the boot stuck for more than 60 seconds. This is apparently related to the clock source module. If I boot with TSC equals unstable, there is no more delay. Now, before you get confused about Debian and the versions of the kernel it ships, yes, these are technically old versions of the kernel, but they are both LTS kernels. So they might not be the newest LTS kernels available. However, they are still being supported. So don't worry about that. When we are talking about an LTS kernel, they don't exactly get new features added. It's just addressing bugs and security issues. So 5.10 first released in 2020 and 6.1 in 2022. So there's probably a bug sometime between these two points that was introduced. And if it's introduced after this point, it's possibly upwards of a 5-year-old bug. In the kernel logs, I have all of this. I already had such a warning with 5.10, but there was no 60 second freeze like with 6.1. The delay is still present in 6.11. That isn't the newest kernel as of recording, but as of the time of this being posted, I have a feeling it probably was. On screen, the last line that is displayed before being frozen is hub:2-0:1.0:5 ports detected. Because of that, I initially thought there was a problem with USB, but actually not, since TSC unstable fixes the delay. The kernel mentions clock source only later in the logs, but the timestamps don't reflect the delay. My last measure is a freeze of about 70 seconds. Yeah, on older hardware, it was common to see longer boots, but when there is a sudden increase in the amount of time it takes to boot, that's obviously a problem. I also noticed that if during that period I do a short press on the power button, it stops the freeze and the boot process continues immediately. The system being used here is an Apple iMac 9.1, back in the days where having Linux running on one of these systems was considerably easier. Now, as is the case for a lot of things, initially, there was no response to this. This was posted in November of 2024. A whole month later, it's like, hey guys, anyone got any ideas here? A couple of days after that, then we got the first actual reply. Initially, he didn't CC that many people in the email, so nobody actually saw it. Which I guess is another reason why a mailing list is not exactly the best way to do the communication. Now, he provided a potential solution and said Debian even suggests this for the iMac hardware you're using and highlights the exact behavior you describe. Maybe this is your efforts. And yes, that is exactly what it was. He is the guy who wrote the wiki page. Also, in this time, the report had gone ahead and did some more research on potentially what the problem is. My findings are as follows. No delay with the following kernel version shipped with Debian when run on an up-to-date bookworm as of today. 5.10.226, 5.19.11, 6.0.10, 6.1.4, 6.1.27.38, 0.66, 0.76, and 0.82. Delay with the following kernel versions, 5.15.15, 6.85, and 6.1.119. So something probably happened between 6.1.82 and 6.1.85. Debian doesn't ship packages for versions between them. Why 5.15.15 also has the delay? Not clear. For the versions where there is a delay, the warning from ClockSource mentioning an unstable clock always comes after the first line that mentions USB, ACPI, bus type USB registered. For the versions which don't have a boot delay, the warning comes from ClockSource mentioning an unstable clock always comes before the line that mentions USB, ACPI, bus type USB registered. However, with 6.1.82, sometimes the unstable clock source message comes after the USB line, but when this happens, both messages are very close in time, less than 50 milliseconds, so that the subsequent USB messages always appear after the clock source message, so the return from clock source might be early enough to not encounter the lock. Basically, in the cases where it is happening, it's happening in slightly different ways, but part of the warning is still there, even in those cases where it's not happening. Now, whilst the extra information is certainly nice to have, it doesn't exactly provide a solution or really point you in much of a useful direction. And obviously, as is always the case, bisection is probably the most foolproof method of narrowing this down. But bisection takes quite a bit of time, and if you can find it without having to do so, that would certainly be nice. But eventually, it had to happen. But when building the kernel from sources, from the stable repo of the kernel to try a git bisect, I couldn't reproduce a case where the warning is before loading a nip with versions I mentioned is working. Maybe I was just lucky, as you mentioned. If the warning comes before loading of USB modules, there is no delay. If it comes after that, there is a delay. If I break slash pause at the beginning of the init script, the warning never comes before. But I don't really understand what is happening and where the problem actually lies. Kernel, systemd, udev, somewhere else. If I add a sleep 5 as the first command in init, it would take ages. So as long as the warning from clock source is not displayed, the delays seem completely wrong. Maybe the USB drivers somehow rely on a reliable clock source for proper functioning. Now here we have a new character, Thomas Gleichner. This is the person who ended up actually fixing the problem. Now, one of the possible solutions mentioned earlier is changing the processor.max C state to 1. That didn't work, obviously. That's weird, but we have no idea what kind of magic the BIOS implements there for power management behind the kernel's back. I assume that it does because this generation of CPUs uses the ACPI processor idle driver, and that disables TSC when it detects that the system supports C states greater than 1. So a couple of terms here that are very important to define. So TSC in this context stands for timestamp counter, basically counting the CPU cycles since the last reset. And C states are basically different levels of the CPU being at idle, basically different levels of sleep state. So a possible solution is setting idle equal to halt. He went and did that, and yeah, that seemed to work. Setting idle equal halt without TSC equals unstable, I haven't encountered the delay. Now, here we get to the actual solution. So on a system, the Intel idle driver was in use, which does not have the magic TSC workarounds like the ACPI processor driver has, but it seems to be loaded preferred. So it's being loaded as the default, even though the other driver has a workaround for a problem. Why is the Intel idle driver so aggressive in taking over, despite the fact that it does not handle the old CPUs, which are known to require the TSC workaround? It handles the ACPI stops in C state 2, but not the TSC oddity, while the original ACPI processor idle driver does the right thing for more than two decades. There is an untested patch below. It just brings the Intel idle driver on par with the original ACPI idle driver to deal with that problem. So basically, what is happening here is in C states 2 or lower, the TSC just stops. It just stops counting, causing a delay. And this patch perfectly fixed the problem, but when you think, if I use old hardware, that means all of the problems have been ironed out. Yes, that's true to an extent, but there comes a point where things get so old that at some point new bugs just get introduced, and if it's old enough that nobody's actually using the hardware, it's very unlikely it's gonna get tested, it's gonna get discovered. It's possible this bug was reported to a distro beforehand, before it actually got to the kernel, but this bug existed in the kernel for multiple years, and nobody really knew, or frankly cared, because if you've a bug with an Intel Core 2 Duo, the amount of people actually affected by that is very, very minimal. And a lot of the people that are going to be affected, you know, maybe they might report a bug, but a lot of them probably just have the system there and don't really do much with it. So are you one of these people that would be affected by the bug? Do you actually have an Intel Core 2 Duo system that you actually use? If you do, I would like to know, and I'd like to know why, actually. Is it something you actively use? Do you just like having old hardware? I would like to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Libero Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and see. What is this?